Hello, my name is Konrad Scheuer. I'm an Applications Engineer at Maxim Integrated, and I'm responsible for our industrial interfaces. Today, I'm going to show you our IO-Link master and device transceivers in a little setup with our reference designs. And now, let's go to the demo. So this is our MaxRefTest 145. This is showcasing a 8-channel IO-Link master. This uses the MAX14819 dual-channel IO-Link master, which also allows the sensor supply and current limiting for the sensor supply. Here we show our MaxRefTest 176. This is a 16-channel IO-Link digital input hub, and this is showing the MAX22515. And for the digital inputs, it uses the MAX22190 and 22192. Here we show our MaxRefTest 171. This is showing a IO-Link distance sensor. It's using the MAX22513, which is has an integrated DC-to-DC converter to allow for the higher current on the sensing element. And here we show our MaxRefTest 164, which is using the MAX14 828. This shows a very simple and small sensor without any DC-to-DC converter. And here we show our MAX22000. This is a universal analog I/O, and this is showcasing an IO-Link universal analog I/O port. So it supports voltage input and output and current input and output. And here we show a little stepper motor demo. So this is an actuator. Now that Trinamic is part of Maxim, we can also show actuators. So here we have our IO-Link temperature sensor. We have the sensing element at the tip, and we have a little microcontroller and the MAX14828. The entire sensor is powered from an LDO, so it's very low power. And if we look at the GUI here, we see the temperature. And if I touch the sensing element, we see the temperature change. So now let's talk about the IO-Link stepper. This is a Trinamic stepper driver, and we are using an IO-Link interface. So if you now look at the GUI, you can type in the target velocity, and you will see the motor rotate at that speed. Now let's talk about the IO-Link universal analog I/O. Here we show our MAX22000, which provides analog input and output functionality. And this is a fully isolated design. And now let's go to the GUI. And here I can enter a voltage. So right now you see 1 volt. And if I change it to 5 volt, then you can see the voltmeter change to exactly 5 volts. And now I want to show the modes. So this board supports high Z mode, of course, which is very low leakage in off mode. And then we have a current input mode, which is minus 20 milliamp to plus 20 milliamp. Then we have a voltage input mode, which is minus 10 volt nominal to plus 10 volt. And then we have an analog output range, which is minus 20 milliamp to plus 20 milliamp, and a voltage output mode, which we just showed, the minus 10 volt to plus 10 volt. I also want to mention we test all these reference designs according to IEC 61131. The digital interface, of course, we also test on the digital input side as well as the analog I/O. And another important thing to mention on the IO-Link Masters. We are working together with TMG and TE Concept. For the sensors, we are working together mostly with TMG and IQ2. So in the demo, you saw that we can make very small IO-Link master and sensors. You can achieve that mostly because our transceivers are very low power and produce very low heat. Well, that concludes my demo. Thanks for watching.